Okay, so we tested the Ford Bronco, the motorized version, using BuWizz 3.0 and 2 power-up motors. And we also used the opportunity to test two more things. One is the constant speed module. And the constant speed module is really great where you want to drive your model very carefully and slowly and don't have to worry about how much power you should apply to keep the same speed. So it's really great for like trial trucks and things like that, where you really need to drive carefully and slow. But if you just wanna tear it out and let it rip, then you don't need a constant speed module, of course. Firmware of the BuWizz automatically adjusts the power of the motor to keep up the speed. So the model drives at a constant speed, no matter if there is an obstacle or not, it will simply increase the power to overcome the obstacle. Also, if you push it, it will start braking to keep up the same speed. So I'm driving really slowly, and when I apply load to the axle, the current increases to the motor to compensate, so it keeps the same speed, and then it drops. And again, the current increases, and then it drops. So it's trying its best to keep the constant speed of the wheels. So we're gonna start nice and slow, and now the electronics will simply divert the more power needed to constantly go uphill. And once we reach the uphill, we should still have the same speed. As you can see, yeah, the model, it keeps its constant speed. Yeah, so now we're gonna go slowly in reverse using the constant speed module. And now the motor brakes on its own. It would be really hard to manually control a model so slowly. So now the electronics is doing all the work. It's like a speed descent, basically. Automatic descent. And it keeps the speed. Even when we're straight on a level ground, it's still driving nice and at the same speed. Now we're going slowly up. And I can see the current increasing because the slope is increasing. And now the current has fallen. And now when it's gonna go down, the current will actually go to zero because the motors will be braking. You see how they brake to keep the speed. Okay, so now I switched the profile and I turned off the constant speed module. And now I'm gonna show you how hard it is to drive the model slowly without a constant speed module. So now I'm doing it all manually and I have to keep adjusting power. And then I have to reduce the power and I would have to brake. You see, it's really hard to do it manually because as soon as you have a downhill, then you have to manually brake. And it's just impossible to drive it as smoothly, manually, at constant speed. We also tested the speed indicator. Now for that, of course, you need a power-up motor driving the model. But so far, so good. And I think this little model reached around 1.3 meters per second. So it has a good balance between speed and torque. And this is the perfect test example because we are using a powered-up L motor to drive the rear wheels. And we currently are seeing that it should be going at around 1.3 meters per second. And I think it's quite close, but we will see. We might still have to fine-tune the parameters. But so far, so good. It actually shows the speed. And can't wait to have this functionality be released so everyone can see how fast their models are going. And I'm really happy how it turned out. We managed to integrate everything really nice and we kept the original looks. We even have the original fake engine working, everything. So yes, it's a good model, and we will be, of course, posting the instructions for this model. And if you want to see more instructions and more BuWizz-powered modified sets, then please remember to subscribe, hit the notification bell. And thank you for watching. Thank you.